NBC 2's First Alert Hurricane Week. Tonight we're focusing on storm science. NBC 2 anchor Kelly Burns and Chief Meteorologist Allyson Ray are live in North Fort Myers at the Edison Sailing Club. Today, scientists with the federal government changed their prediction for the Atlantic hurricane season. Ladies, not what we want to hear.
No, not at all. And a lot of this, Kelly, has to do with the water temperature. And, you know, it's typical for them to update the forecast throughout the year. And we think, hey, we have an El Nino. It's going to be great. We have wind shear. But that never tells the whole story. And that's what we try to really focus on, is that it's not about the forecast, the seasonal forecast. It's about where those storms go. And one thing to note is that even though we have maybe an above average season, we've had seasons where they're below average and we've still had an active year. Think about Hurricane Andrew. That year we only had 7 named storms, just 7. And we had Hurricane Andrew. So this year it could be above average. That's not what we're going to be focused on. We're focused on where these storms go and their impacts. And we know about impacts. Last year we had all the flooding.
Let's go ahead and show you some of the video of this area, North Shore Park, right across the Caloosahatchee. This park, we would have been underwater by about 2 feet right there. Take a look. You can see, looking into downtown Fort Myers and along the river, the impact after and during and after the hurricane. Because we got, what, about 9 foot of storm surge?
Yep.
20 miles away from the Gulf of Mexico.
We are over 20 miles from the shores of Sanibel. And also, when we talk about the destruction of Ian, we focus a lot on the storm surge. We focus a lot on Fort Myers Beach, the tourism industry, the boating, the fishing industry. Mm-hmm. But also, there is a whole nother huge industry that we have here in Florida, citrus. And they had their impacts, too. They had Irma, then they had Ian. And I talked to the citrus farmers and the citrus growers here in Southwest Florida. And there's more to the story even beyond hurricanes. We kind of have to dive into that. Here it is.
We used to have, you know, 800,000 acres of grove in Florida, and we're now down to less than half that.
Florida's main crop.
2004, I think, is when we peaked at 242 million boxes.
Is getting squeezed out.
This year we will produce less than 15, well, about 15 million boxes.
Tamiami Citrus CFO and VP Ron Mahan walked me through Sadie Cypress Citrus Grove and the challenges of citrus growers. If it isn't the climate.
Actually, a year and a half ago, we had that freeze in February.
Yeah.
Over the weekend. We probably lost $2 or $3 million from that freeze.
It's the hurricanes.
Now, our groves further north that were in it in hurricane level winds had 60, 70, 80, 90% of their fruit blown off.
Or the pest.
In the 80s, it was a disease called tristasia. We've had canker in the past. About 10, 15 years ago, a new disease came out called greening.
Greening produces an autoimmune response in the trees. It doesn't allow the nutrients to properly disperse, turning leaves yellow. The problem then becomes twofold during a storm. Most citrus groves are prepared for storms with windbreaks and water pumps. But a tree impacted by greening isn't able to withstand as much as a healthier tree.
The stress from the storm would have caused X amount of damage, but now it's X times whatever.
Currently, just 20% of juice is from Florida. The rest is imported from Mexico and Brazil. As a farmer, Mahan says he's a natural optimist, and new research has given him some hope.
Well, we have some new therapies that are showing significant promise for the disease. Well, the antimicrobials just received their official label less than a year ago.
It may not be possible to ever get back to that max of 242 million boxes of oranges in a year, mostly due to fewer groves remaining in Florida. But Mahan is hopeful to get above 50 million boxes in a few years. And if hurricane seasons can cooperate, perhaps near 100 million boxes down the road.
The trees are healthy, and our issue now is for the industry, you know, we lost a lot of money. And it's tough for growers to keep putting the money into next year's crop if we didn't have money that we, from sales of last year's crop.
And they are still waiting on a bill to be passed in order to get any type of federal funding back.
Yeah, as we spoke with Commissioner Brian Hammond earlier, a lot of federal funding takes a long time. And for all of this area in North Fort Myers to see any kind of money for housing, it could be a year or two down the road before they actually get the money.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be hard.
Yes. I'm going to toss it back to Peter in the studio. All the-